Hi everyone, my name is Marie Cruz and I'm a Senior Developer Advocate at Grafana Labs. In this beginner-friendly video tutorial, I'm going to share with you everything that I learned about flame graphs that you should know. By the end of this video tutorial, you should also know what data a flame graph needs so you can visualize it correctly in Grafana. To understand flame graphs, an understanding of profiling is quite essential. Profiling is a technique used in software development to measure and analyze the runtime behavior of a program. Profiling tools collect data about various aspects of the software's execution, such as the CPU usage, memory usage, or input-output operations. You can use the collected data to identify any bottlenecks, resource-intensive code, or inefficient algorithms that may be causing the software to run slowly or consume excessive resources. Profiling is often done in a snapshot manner, meaning it captures a snapshot of the program's behavior at a specific time. Continuous profiling takes the concept of profiling a step further by continuously monitoring and analyzing the behavior of your program. Instead of just capturing a snapshot, continuous profiling allows you to collect data continuously while your program is running. There are many profiling tools out there, one of which is Grafana Pyroscope. To learn more about Pyroscope, check out the useful links in the video description below. Anyway, as you can imagine, the data that's collected by a profiling tool can be thousands and thousands and thousands of lines long, and it can be very difficult to understand. So if you quickly want to discover the hottest code paths that are time-consuming or resource-intensive, using a flame graph can quickly point you to where optimizations are needed. To understand how to read the flame graph, let's consider this scenario of a day in my life as a developer advocate, which is inspired by Mika Rehar's explanation of a flame graph. A typical day for me consists of the following: doing the morning school run, doing some admin work such as reading and replying to emails or Slack messages, doing actual Grafana work, whether that's learning about a new visualization type or updating some tutorials, walking the dogs, having a break, reading and replying to more emails and Slack messages, more Grafana work such as video recording, joining any meetings that I need to be part of, doing the afternoon school run, having a second break, more Grafana work such as video editing, and finally replying to any unread emails and Slack messages. We then end up with this visualization. Flame graphs are not time series data, which means that your data will not be visualized in a time ascending order. A flame graph will group similar things together and it can give you a quick overview of what's happening. So for this example, you can see where I spend most of my time by simply looking at the width of each horizontal block. And I can also see which areas I can optimize even more, such as maybe reading or replying to emails and Slack messages less. In Grafana, you must format your data as a nested set model to visualize it effectively as a flame graph. Your data must have a few required fields such as the label, the level, the self, and the total value. The level represents the nesting level of the items, with 0 being the top level or the parent item. As the level increases, the further it is from the parent item. These items are the child items. The label is simply the name of the item itself. The self refers to the actual value of the resource usage of a specific item or a function, but excluding the resources used by the child items or the sub-functions. Finally, the total refers to the combined value or the resource usage of an item or a function along with all of its child items and any sub-functions that it's gonna call. Now that you have an overview of profiling and flame graphs, let's look at how a flame graph visualization works in Grafana. Okay, as usual, let's add a new visualization to our dashboard, change our visualization type from time series to a flame graph, and make sure that the Grafana test data data source is selected. Then under the scenario, I'm going to pick the flame graph scenario. Let's explore the data first by going to the table view. You can see that our data contains different labels for our items and the level of the items, the self, and the total value. Returning to the visualization view, Grafana displays a table format along the flame graph by default. You can toggle the view easily by clicking the flame graph or the top table view. Looking at the table view, by default, the table is sorted by the self value, but it can be reordered by the total value or the label or symbol name by clicking the column headers. Clicking the symbol name or the search icon highlights the function in the flame graph. Besides the search icon, another icon shows the sandwich view for the function when clicked. The sandwich view shows all the function's colors on the top and all the colors at the bottom. Focusing on just the flame graph, clicking a function will show a drop-down of additional actions that you can call. The focus block makes it easier to drill down into the smaller parts of the flame graph by focusing on the stack trace call from the parent function up to that particular child function. The copy function name is straightforward and the sandwich view is similar to what you already saw from the table view. You can change the color scheme by their value or by their package name to visually tie functions from the same package together. And there you have it. In this beginner-friendly video tutorial, I've shown you what flame graphs are and how you can easily configure a flame graph visualization in Grafana. Check out our documentation if you want to learn more about flame graphs, profiling, or Grafana Pyroscope in general, which you can all find in the video description below. I hope you found this video useful, and if you do, let us know in the comments. And as always, happy visualizing!